Now we welcome Dr. Sabita Banu. She will be speaking on quantum computing and their application.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thanks for giving me the opportunity to share my valuable insights on quantum computing. Is my slides visible?
Yes, it is visible, ma'am.
Thank you so much. So today I'm going to just discuss about some basics of quantum computing, and as we already know that quantum computing, it is an emerging topic, and we are integrating the quantum compute, like quantum physics, quantum mechanics with the computation or computer science to solve some complex problems. So we are going to see the basics of quantum computing and some applications where it has been applied to solve the problems. So I'm going to cover about the introduction about quantum computing, then the technologies used for the communication, then how it is secured by using the quantum computing algorithms, how can we secure all the like the transactions or in healthcare, whatever domains we are working, how can we secure those, and then how it is implemented in all domains. So first of all, talking about quantum computing, it is like it is a concept of quantum mechanics or quantum physics integrated with the computer science to solve some particular problems. So normally in traditional computing, we used to solve some problems based on the zeros and ones, which means to turn on or off. But in quantum computing, the same traditional like in traditional computing, we use zero or one, but in quantum we are going to use qubits. So in traditional computing, it will be either zero or one, but here it will be zero and one at the same time. Simultaneously, we can achieve both the states at the same time. So this is the basic advantage of quantum computing to solve many complex problems. So we have many features of quantum mechanics. So superposition, as I already told you, that it can be in the both the states, either zero or one, or simultaneously at the same states. So this is an added advantage. And another concept which is called as a entanglement. So when one of the state it is changing, it will affect the other, or it is reflected in the other state also. So it is also an another added advantage of quantum computing. And talking about gates, normally in traditional computing we use Boolean functions or we use logic gates to solve all the problems, but here we are using Boolean functions with the help of quantum gates to solve the complex problems. And the algorithms used for solving all those problems are particularly, we have five different algorithms, but among those algorithms we are mostly using only Shor's algorithm and Grover's algorithm. So these two algorithms are very very helpful in solving or for finding out the factorization for large numbers, and for finding out the quadratic equation or a quadratic speedup for unstructured search problems. So it helps like these two algorithms helps in increasing the efficiency of the quantum computing. And as we are connected with the internet, everything it is shared over the internet. We are passing the information only through the internet. So when it is shared in the with the help of internet, nothing is secured. So with the help of quantum computing, we can do it. Like we can secure the transmission of messages by using the quantum key distribution. So QKD. which means quantum key distribution. So it leverages the quantum properties to create secure communication channels. So with the help of key distribution between the sender and transmitter, we can attain the secure communication of information between the sender and the receiver, achieving the confidentiality and integrity. So when it is using all these communication principles, or when it is using the quantum key distribution, we used to face some challenges, like when it cannot be achieved in quantum computers or networks or cryptography or machine learning. So with the help of quantum concepts used in computational science, we can achieve all these, or we can face all these challenges. And as I told you, quantum computing, it is a booming technology. Everyone starts to explore the concept of physics and mechanics in all the research areas. So particularly quantum computing, it is applied in all the optimization, like finding out the best way to solve some problems. And it is also used in material science domain, then for drug discovery. Then if we talk about research, or if we talk about communication, it is used in all the telecommunication industry. Then we even use in 5G and 6G for achieving the secure data transmission. And we can even privacy is also secured while data transmission. And if it is applied in finance and banking sector, as we know, everything, it is over the internet. We are there are millions of transactions ongoing, so we can even secure all those transactions by applying this concept. We can even integrate with the blockchain, and it can be applied in the banking sector to perform the secure transactions. And if it is in the form of healthcare, all the we have so many gadgets to monitor our health and transmit the information from the gadgets to the doctors who's monitoring our health. So it is even very helpful to apply these concepts to secure the information in the data exchange. So it is also very helpful when it is applied in the healthcare. And talking about the research, though it is interdisciplinary, quantum physics, mechanics, it is totally different from the computer science, but it is integrated these days, and they are applying in many various departments or various sectors, and they are collaborating to find out or to solve very, very complex or very new problems. And it is also applied in investment to achieve the quantum safe infrastructure, and it is also used in communication. Basically, this quantum communication concept, it gives a secure data transmission. When it is transferred over the internet, it gives a safe transmission environment. So this is what I have prepared for the quantum computing. Any doubts? Any questions?
Thank you, Dr. Sabita, for your kind words. Thank you for the participation.
Okay, thank you. I thank Dr. Inamullah Khan and his team, Wakar Abbas, then Abdullah Urus, then Rukshar, everyone. Okay, thank you. Thank you so much for providing this opportunity.